hope you're ready. Here are over 70 asthma facts coming to you in record time. Let's go. Nearly 25 million Americans have asthma today, and the number is climbing fast. By 2020, 1 in 10 people may have asthma. 7 million American kids have asthma. It's the number one chronic disease in children, period. Every year, there's over 2 million emergency department visits and about 500,000 hospitalizations for asthma. It'll happen to 12 people while you watch this video. Today, 9 people will die from asthma. Most of these deaths are preventable. You are more likely to have asthma if you are female, under 17 years old, of Black or Puerto Rican descent, or live in the Northeast. Richmond, Virginia is the asthma capital of the U.S., followed by the 3 cities in Tennessee: Knoxville, Memphis, and Chattanooga. Every year, kids miss nearly 11 million school days, and adults lose 36 million days of work and activities due to asthma. That's over 128,000 years worth of missed time. It costs us $30 billion. In most cases, when treated properly, asthma can be managed and the impact of a kid's life can be minimized. Still, 3 out of 4 kids with asthma today say it interferes with their life. Less than half of kids with asthma tell people when it causes them to stop or interrupt activities. The top reason given were embarrassment and not wanting to make others worry. Parents are twice as likely to be embarrassed about their kids' asthma than their children. Asthma is nothing to be ashamed of. Here are some people who have asthma and didn't let it stop them. Soccer star David Beckham, rocker Alice Cooper, late actress Elizabeth Taylor, boxer Shannon Briggs, football champion The Bus Bettis, track star Jackie Joyner Kersee, and presidents John F. Kennedy, Calvin Coolidge, Teddy Roosevelt, Woodrow Wilson, and Martin Van Buren. Even Beethoven had asthma when he wrote his 5th symphony. Many people with asthma are never diagnosed or never seek treatment. Some are even afraid to call their symptoms asthma. But being diagnosed can be a good thing. Your healthcare provider can provide you with a customized plan that for many can be a big difference in your life. The classic symptoms of asthma are chest tightness, cough, shortness of breath, and wheezing. You don't need all of them to have asthma. Asthma can come in all shapes and sizes. If you tend to get a lot of chest cold, wake up at night with coughing, have trouble breathing with exertion, or even have some of these symptoms along with allergies, it can't hurt to see a doctor to see if they can help. Here are some facts about asthma treatment. There are generally 3 kinds of asthma treatments. Short-acting medicines like albuterol that help with symptoms when they occur. Long-acting daily medication that helps prevent and manage symptoms. And environmental control and trigger avoidance, which are things you can do to help prevent having asthma trouble. Anti-inflammatory therapy with inhaled corticosteroid is considered the best medicine for people with persistent asthma, but only 2 in 10 people with asthma actually regularly use these kinds of medications. Inhaled corticosteroids have nothing to do with the bad steroids used to enhance performance. Very few asthma patients know how to actually use their inhaler device properly. Actually, in one study, only 1 in 43 medical professionals were able to correctly use an inhaler device. If you have an inhaler, take 5 minutes to read the direction. It's important that your medication gets into your lungs. Every patient with asthma is supposed to have an asthma action plan. Less than 30% have them. An action plan should show you what your asthma triggers are, what medications you should have, when and how to take them, how to identify troublesome symptoms, and what to do if they occur. Most asthma can be controlled, but many people aren't really sure what asthma control actually means. If you can't say yes to all of the following, your asthma may not be under good enough control. You are symptom-free during the day, almost every day. You never wake up with asthma symptoms. You never miss work or school because of asthma. You do not have to limit your activities, even sports and exercise. You do not visit the emergency room or hospital because of asthma. You do not experience troublesome side effects from asthma medication. If you can't say yes to all of these, it's time to talk to a healthcare provider and see what they can do to help you achieve better control. That was a lot of information, but the most important one is that all people with asthma deserve a life free from the disease. If you like this video, please take a moment to subscribe to our channel. Thank you.